So we're working on the understanding the Tikun of Nidah. So we have here the book of it's called Sidur Benyyahu, which has many Tikunim according to the Rashash, the students of Rav Dweik HaKohen, Rav Shul Dweik HaKohen, that is was the Rosh Yeshiva of Bethel about 150 years ago or something like that. So his students, as far as I understand, wrote this book. It's all based on the Rashash and the Arizal. Okay, so let's read together. All of this tikkun is according to Shaar HaKodesh. Ze lashon Rav Zal, the language, the words of the Arizal. Abel Nidah Ratzah Lomar Rachman Litzlan, someone that was had a relationship with the Nidah woman, that she didn't go to the mikveh. Itane Pad Taniyot, should fast 82 fast days. וכוון כי החטא הזה פוגם בשם YKK. The mediation should be that the blemish was done in this name, YKK. אני רוצה מראשי תיבות, that comes out of the name of the פסוק, השם אושיה המלך. Right? השם אושיה המלך יענו ביום קראנו, so the יוד of the YKVK, the ה' of אושיה and the ה' of המלך. העניין הוא, so what is about? כי כל עוד ה' משתיהם, each one, of those hays, יש בה שני ציורים. It has two kinds of shapes. How to do it? It's hard to see here, but it's dalet vav or dalet yud. Okay, so you can make the hay that the you have. This is like dalet, and the little thing in the middle can be vav or yud, right? Instead, we call hay mishtem. So each one of those two hays. שני הציורים הנזל have those two ways. So if you do דלת וו is 10, דלת יוד is 14, right? So you have two times hey hey, so you have 24 times 2, right, for the two hays, right? So that's yeah, נגמטרה כף דלת 24, ובית פעמים twice 24 mem chet is 48. Ve'im ot yud, and you add to that the first yud, right? Arei nun chet, so that will be the 58. Im kolel hem b'gematria nida. So with the kolel, the is nun tet, which is the same gematria of the word nida. Onam ma she'tzarich li'itanot pei bet. So why do we need 82 yom days? Fish call odd hay because each one of those hays, Yeshba Gimel Miluim, have also another way of three ways of Milui. Velohem, the hay yud, when we're saying hay, it can be hay yud, hay aleph, or hay hay. Right? Three Miluim of hay. Vem Gimatria Lamed aleph. So all together, those three have the Gimatria of 31. Im ken shne hayin, so if you do 31. Times 2, Yalu Samech Bet is 62. Vim Yud, and with the Yud, with the Milui, right? So Yud Vav Dalet, which is 20. Arei Pei Bet, so this is 82, right? So again, this Yud KK is with the Milui, right? So Yud with the Milui, Hey with the 3 Miluim, Hey with the 3 Miluim, all together is 82. גם יכוון כי בעוון נידה גרם שעות ה' so also because of the sin of nidah is causing the ה' הייתה נא ונדה to move around. So what does it mean? It means that the ה' of the י"ק ו"ק, right, the last ה' which is representing the שכינה is going away, is going away from its place. It makes a separation. כי זה פירוש נידה נד ה'. This is the meaning of the word נידה. That is not hay, to move around the hay. והייתה בתשובה, now when we are doing תשובה, we are repenting, coming back to Hashem, תחזור למקומה, so this hay goes back to its place, ותתיישב, and be settled in its place. ומכל יום ימי תעין היטב, each day of those days of fasting, יכוון בשם הנזל, we have to meditate it on those different names, all of those different combinations that we discussed, this is the meditation of the תיקון, כוונות נזכרות, גם מתגלגל בשלג, and also to do the rolling in the snows, שבע פעמים, seven times, Yan ki achri ve'ovish, because he destroyed and brought down to dryness seven nechalei malchut, seven rivers of the malchut, of the Shechina, meaning the source of abundance that comes down to the malchut, to the sphere of malchut. ובתשובתו, and then when he's repenting, יחזרו להיות נמשכים כבתחילה, it will go back to rejuvenate and to have the sustenance coming down to the malchut. Okay, so this is basically the meditation for the tikkun. And now, here we have the nosach, the words of how, what to say in the vidui. So, according to my tradition of the Yeshiva Betel, it should be done when the person is in the prayer of Mincha, of the fast day, and when before he's saying Baruch Atah Hashem Shomea Tefillah, so to say this extra prayer inside of the Amidah. But if for some reason it was not possible for someone, so it can be said separately. It doesn't have to be specifically in the Mincha. It can be different time. And there is, like we saw yesterday, the tradition of Rav Yehuda Ptaya in the book Ruchot Mesaprot, that here he brings general tikkun for all kinds of different sins, and he says to do the prayer whenever through the day, separately when you are by yourself in a separate room, bare feet. Okay, that's a little bit of a different way of tikkun. Anyhow, let's read the prayer here. Anenu avinu anenu biyom tzom ta'anitenu. Right? Answer us, Hashem, our Father, in the day of our fast. כי בצורה גדולה אנחנו, we are in a big trouble. אל כי חטאנו, אבינו פשענו, because we did the sins and crimes לפניך, in front of you, ועברנו על כריתות ומיתות בית דין. We transgress the sins that their punishment for them is karet and death in the hands of בית דין. על מצוות עשה ועל מצוות לא תעשה, positive commandments, negative commandments, ונפיהם, and the branches that come out of them, מדברי קבלה ומדברי סופרים, the words of the prophets and the words of the sages, ובנו על הנידה. Okay, so this, until here, this is a general, like, beginning for any תיקון. Yeah, now we're starting to get more specific about this specific תיקון, and it will be different in other תיקונים for other sins. בנו על הנידה, we lived with the נידה woman, בעלנו אדם. Okay, so it gives here it gives like all the different possibilities of going against the prohibition of Nidah. Okay, so one thing is the simple, just to live with Nidah. Another thing is ba'alnu ro'ad dam mechamat tashmish, to live with a woman that when she's getting an intimate relationship, so she sees dam, she sees blood. So even though she was not Nidah, it was not her period, but still it has the halakhic position like Nida. So that's another kind of the same sin. Lo pirashnu me'aisha samuch levista. So according to the halakhot of Nida, when couple are married and they are supposed to live together, but the wife supposed to get her period soon, so in that last day or night before she's supposed to see her period, they are not supposed to be together. So lo pirashnu me'aisha samuch levista, it means that even though she didn't get the period, but we went against the words of the rabbi that told us not to be with our wife in that time that before they're supposed to get their period. וכשהיו תאורות ונטמאו מחמת השמיש, if a woman, there is a possibility that a married couple, they are, God forbid, there's some ladies that they have some sensitivity, and then when they get intimate, so they see blood because of their relationship, and then she becomes to be Nida, and then the husband is supposed to stop being with her. But the right way to do it is to wait until he is not hard anymore and then to go out. And the wrong way to do it, which is another way of sin, is to go out when, like, immediately, and that's also a sin. So this, that's the explanation of those words. Lo nizharnu mitumat yuledet, we were not careful from the impurity of a woman that gave birth. That giving birth is also makes a woman to be nidah. So this is like different ways of a woman to get to status of nida. So there's I can't really explain like all of the details between the differences of the differences between like a woman that gives birth a regular period and zava. It's kind of a sickness that it's there's also like blood coming out. So it's basically the same prohibition goes in the same box. ולא נהגנו שבעה נקיים. So after the period is over, so for a woman to go to the mikveh, not to be nida, so she's supposed to count 7 clean days without seeing blood. So if she goes to the mikveh, if she didn't count the 7 clean days, so then she's still nida because she didn't count the days. So if yeah, so that's a part of the confession here. Be'ra'ada tipat dam. So even if she sees a drop of blood, even though it's not a full period, but like a drop of blood is already enough that she will become nida. So if she saw a drop of blood and she ignored it, so basically she became to be nida. And right, lo pirashnu midam betulim. Not okay, a virgin that they're also the kind of blood, but is like it's a different status of blood, the blood of the virginity. So someone that ignored that and being, if he got married with a virgin and then she had blood after the first relationship, and then she didn't go to the mikveh afterwards, so that's a different status because according to the like written Torah, so this blood is pure blood, but according to the Rabbanan, so she have to go to the mikveh anyhow. So if that was ignored, so that's a different kind of a prohibition. Ktamim, like stains, meaning if there was stains of blood and she ignored it, there's a whole like discussions of like what is the size and of the stains and where it was shown and what is, so we can't like go over all of the halakhot of Nidah here, but really to understand all of those concepts, so someone have to like learn the halakhot of Nidah, otherwise it's very very not clear. So really I am recommending to anyone that is like want to do this tikkun to really go over all of those halakhot, and then those concepts will be much much clearer. So to the stains, kovar v'satot, any way that the woman gets a certain routine of what happens to her when she's receiving her period. So when this routine happens, and so she knows that she was supposed to get her period then, and she ignored the fact that she's supposed to get her period and she lived with her husband, so that will be another sin, even though she didn't get the period. Ve'lo shimashnu be'edim, in some certain circumstances, so husband and wife supposed to the wife supposed to check herself before the relationship to make sure that she is not nida. So if they didn't do that, so that's called that they didn't have the edim. It's like witnesses, but it means the checking before nida. ולא תבלו נשותינו בלילה, if the time to go to the mikveh is in the night, but if she didn't go to in the night and she went in the day afterwards, so then they supposed to wait until the next night. So if that happened that she didn't go in the night and she went in the day, and then they lived in the day, so that's another kind of a sin that like that she didn't have the night coming. לא נדחקנו מהם באכילה ושתייה. So if a woman is nida, so there's all kinds of halachot of the like how the husband and wife supposed to like just eat together and like hang around together. So it's supposed to be like different. So someone that he didn't keep those halachot, so that's part of the confession. Ma she'ezhiru bedam b'hem chachamim. Whatever the sages have warned us, anachnu. Okay, so until here, that was the confession for all of the different things that are related with Nida. Right, and here this continuation is going back to more, to be more general for all kinds of different sins. Anachnu v'avotenu v'anshei beitenu. We, our forefathers, are the people of our house. Kol ha'baim mishorshei nefesh ruach neshama. The people that are related with the roots of our nefesh ruach neshama. Malbusheim, the garments of the nefesh ruach neshama. Hakorvim lahem, those individuals that are close to them. Shemiklalut of all of the atzilut b'riya yitzira asiya. Abiyah is atzilut b'riya yitzira asiya. All of the spiritual worlds. וכל פרטי הביאה, all of the details of אצילות בריאה יצירה עשייה, וכל פרצוף וספירה, every פרצוף and every ספירה, פרטי הביאה, of the details of אצילות בריאה יצירה, פנימיות וחיצוניות, internal, external, פנימי ומקיף, internal and surrounding, יושר ועיגולים, straight and circles, בגלגול זה ובגלגולים שעברו, in this lifetime and previous reincarnations, that have passed, מיום שנברא העולם, from the day of the creation of the world, עד היום הזה, until this day, שנינו ושילשנו עליהם כמה פעמים, we did it two and three times and even more, אנחנו וכל אחד מ-248 איברים, we and each one of the 248 organs of ourselves, ו-365 גידים, and the 365 tendons, מוח ועצמות, the marrow of the bones, and the bones of של גופנו ונפשנו, our body, and נפש, רוח, נשמה, שמכל הביאה, of all of אצילות בריאה יצירה עשייה, כל פרצוף וספירה, each one of the structures of the ספירות, and the ספירות themselves, of כללות ופרטות, the general and details of the worlds of אצילות בריאה יצירה עשייה, ופגבנו בשם, and we made a blemish in the name YKK, like we explained in the introduction here, Yud Rebet Paim Hey, the Yud and twice Hey, as we see here. Kol Hey Mishtem, each one of those two Heys, Metsuyeret Beshnei Tziurim Kaze, have these paintings. It's not really clear here. It's supposed to be Daled. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So this is Daled, right? You see the Daled? So that's Daled Yud and that's Daled Vav. Okay? That's Daled Vav. Dalet Yud, Dalet Vav, Dalet Yud, Dalet Vav, right? Of each one of those heads. Ha'olim 48, that is coming to the count of 48, in Mispar Yud, with the extra Yud, Ve'akolel, and the general that includes all of them, all together, Kemispar Nidah, is the Gematria of Nidah, which is 59. Pagavnu Benayi, Ube'otiyot, Yud, Nun, Hey. So we did the blemish in the Netzachot Yesod, which is related to those organs, about Yod and the letters of Nai, which is Yud Nun Hey, the Shechina of the Shechina, Ha'olim Kemispar Adni, which comes to the count of Adni. Ve'gramu LaShechina, and we cause the Shechina, which is the Hey Tata, the last Hey of the Yud Kiva, okay? Liot Na V'Nada, to move around, to be separated מהוו from the vav of the yud ki vav kei בגלות down to the exile ונשפלה לאפר it came down to the ashes והובשנו והחרבנו and we destroyed it and made dry שבעה נחלי המלכות the seven rivers of the מלכות וקלקלנו צינורותיהם we ruined the pipes of that transformed the abundance and we prevented the dough of the buttons. Pagano Beshoresh Hachamesh Gvuot, we blemished the root of the five judgments, Amekubotot Bedat Alion, that are gathered in the upper Dat. Mepirtei Parzufi Adat Alion, the details of the Parzufim of the upper Dat, Vatachton and the lower Dat, the Keter Chochma Bina, the Zah, of the Sefirot of Keter and Chochma and Bina of Zeir and Pin, בקיבוץ החמש גבורות שביסוד, and the gathering of those five גבורות in the יסוד, ופרטי פרצופי היסוד, and the details of the פרצופים of the יסוד, the כחב דזה of the ספירות כתר חוכמה בינה of the זעיר אנפין, ובחסדים המתפשטים, the חסדים that expands through בחגת, in the חסד גבור התפארת, פרטי פרצופי חגת דחגת, ונאי דזה. So the פרצופים that are called חגת of חגת, and חגת of נאי of the זעיר אנפין. בקיבוץ חמישה חסדים שביסוד, the gathering of the five חסדים inside of the יסוד, ופרטי פרצופי היסוד, the details of the פרצופים of the יסוד, חגת ונאי וחגת דזה, right? So it's the same thing that we had here. גם פגענו בעולם העשייה, also we made a blemish in the world of עשייה, ותיפרד מהיצירה, and it made a separation between the world of עשייה and the world of יצירה, ויפרדו תפארת ומלכות, and that made the separation between the ספירות of תפארת ומלכות, איש מהלכיו, one from his brother, ויעתק צור ממקומו, and it moved the source from its place, ותרד מלכות העשייה, and the מלכות of עשייה have came down, בגר דקליפה into the first three ספירות of the negative side. ופגענו בעולם היצירה, we made a blemish in the world of היצירה, ותיפרד מהבריאה, and it made a separation from the בריאה, ויפרד התפארת מהיות תחת אמו. So the ספירה of תפארת have moved from his mother meaning בינה, והתק צור ממקומו, it moved the source core, ותרד המלכות דעשייה, and then it moved מלכות of עשייה even lower, בגימל המציאות הקליפה, to the middle ספירות of the negative side of חגד. פגענו בעולם הבריאה, and also the blemish got to the world of בריאה, ויפרד מהאצילות, and it came down from the אצילות, פרד האם, היי אילאה, מעל הבן, תפארת, and that made the separation from the היי, which is אימא, בינה, from תפארת, which is זעיר אנפין, which is the וו, ישראל, ויעתק צור ממקומו, and that moved the source from its place, ותרד מלכות דעשייה, and then מלכות of עשייה went even lower, לגימל תחתונות, in the three lower ספירות of the קליפה of the negative side. וגרמנו פירוד בדלת אותיות שמך, הוויה ברוך הוא. And we made the separation of the four letters of the יוד קי וו קי, your holy name. But, okay, so until here that's the confession, meaning the result, the spiritual result of the sin. ואתה איננו שמים ומתחרטים, now we are repenting and regretting, חרטה גמורה, a full regret, ובוכים ומתוודים, we cry and confess in front of you, Hashem, אבינו פשענו לפניך, we made sins in front of you, Hashem, אנא Hashem, please, למענך, for your own sake, סלחנה, please forgive us, מחלנה, and give us atonement, כפרנה, לחטאים, לאבונות ולפשעים, for all of our sins and wrongdoings, and crimes that we חטאתי ועביתי ושפשעתי לפניך, that I made sins and blemished and crimes in front of you, מעודי from ever until עד היום הזה, until this day. יהי רצון לפניך, אדוני אלוהי ולבותיי, be the desire in front of you, Hashem, my God and the God of my fathers, שאתה התקרבו והתייחדו, that now the letters, אותיות שמך הגדול, the letters of your holy name will come together and unite, יוד קי וו קי, right? ויתייחדו הוויה ועדנות, and also the יוד קי וו קי will unite with אדני, בייחוד השלם, right? This is the combination of יוד קי וו קי and אדני, ויהיה מיוד וחרבי ודמי, and the minimizing my fat and blood, שנתמעט בתענית זה, that was minimized in this fast, yeah, that will be חשוב ומקורא לפניך, will be important and accepted in front of you, כאילו הקרבנו על גבי המזבח, as if we have sacrificed it on top of the altar, קורבן אישה, like a full sacrifice, on בית המקדש, כגלו וידוע, לפני כיסא כבודיך, that you know, and it is revealed in front of you, בזמן שבית המקדש קיים, as long as the בית המקדש exists, אדם חוטא ומביא לפניך קורבן, a person is making a sin and brings in front of you an atonement of sacrifice, והם מקריבים ממנו רק חרבו ודמו, and what is getting the burned on the altar is the fat and blood. Mitkapelo, and that gives the atonement. Because of our sins, אין לנו מקדש, we don't have the temple, ולא מזבח, ולא כהן שיחפר בעדנו, we don't have the altar, we don't have the כהן that will give us the atonement. יהי רצון לפניך, let it be your will, השם אלוקיי ואלוקי אבותיי, the God of my God and the God of my fathers, שיהיה מיעוט חלבי ודמי, that minimizing my fat and blood שנתמעט היום לפניך בתעניתי, that got minimized in front of you in my fast, חשוב ומקובל לפני כוסף כבודיך, is important and accepted in front of your throne of honor, of glory, כאילו הקרבתים על גבי המזבח, as if I sacrificed it on the altar, בכוח חלב ודם, and the strength of the fat and blood שנתמעט ממני, that have minimized for me, יתעורר סוד בית זיווגי מם בית דחך וגרון, that will arouse the two unities of the throat and palate of the that name Yud-Kei-Vav. Gematria mem bet, so the gematria of this name is 42. Vatiot Ekeye, and the letters of Ekeye Pashut Umilui, Umilui Amilui, right, so it's Ekeye, with this is the simple, and then milui is aleph k yud k, and then the milui of the milui is aleph k yud k. So all together, m otiot is 41 letters, ba'kolel, and the general that includes everything together is 42. Kemispar chelev adam, and all together is the gematria of chelev adam, which is the fat and blood that got minimus. ובכן התמתקו מספר אותיות דמילוי ריבוע שם אלוקים, and also it will do the sweetening of the number of the letters of the מילוי of the ריבוע of the name of אלוקים, which is, this is the name of אלוקים, right? So, אלף, למד, ק, יוד, מם, this is the name of אלוקים, this is the last one. So the ריבוע, it means אלף, אלף, למד, אלף, למד, ק, Aleph Lamed K Yud, Aleph Lamed K Yud Mem. Right, this is the ribua of the Elohim. But as you see, the name of Elohim is small, and the milui, the extra letters, is big, because we're counting for the gematria just the milui, without the small letters. Okay, so the small letters here just to make it clear what we're looking at, but really it's not coming into the count. Now let tiferet. So all of that comes. It's not tiferet. It's taf. Is the count of all of that letters is 800. Taf is 400. So taf is 800. Mispar otiot de eser pa'amim Elokim. And if we add to that 10 times name of Elokim milui with the milui asher kol echad me'en em yud gimel, that each one of them have 13 letters yud gimel otiot. So 10 times 13 is 130, right? Kal is 130. Yalul mispar tanit, so altogether, the taf and the kal altogether is the number of tanit, which is fast. Ubalot reach hevel pi, in the time that the smell of my mouth comes up, because when a person is fasting, so you have bad smell coming over his mouth. So even though it sounds a little bit funny, but it has a whole meditation for itself. Meshazo yulemaro, that will do a certain tikkun, that it will enlight the letters of Shem Yud Ben Hehin and Bet Hehin, the yud and the two heys, right, which is the same gematria, the same idea of the meditation that we started with in the introduction, right? Yud and two heys. We call hey mishtem, each one of those two heys, male beyudin ve'alefin be'ein, have the milui of the yudin, alefin, hein, right? So that's three ways how to do the milui of the heys. Olim shnayim shishim, that comes to the count of 62. Mispar Yud, and with the extra 20 of the Yud Vav Daled, which is the Yud with the Milui, Yalu Pei Bet, that will be the number 82. Ve'tashuv v'tivne chorvotecha, and you will come back to rebuild your the destructions. Ve'eretz arisotecha tivne v'tikonen, the destruction of that happened in the in Eretz Israel, in Yerushalayim, in the temple. Ve'tashuv hei tata'a, and the last hey of the Yudki Vavki will come up. L'alot le'irot et ne Adon Hashem will come up back to the unity of the Yudki Vavki. Ve'asiyat itchaber ba'etzira, the world of Asiyah will come up to connect with the Yetzira. וגם תשוב היית תאה לעלות אל בית אימה, and then the last day will come up to the first of the Yudkei Vavkei, ותעלה וו אימה, and it, that will elevate the וו with it, ונקרב בעל הבית אל הלוקים, and that will, it brings, it's a certain pasuk that he is saying over here, but literally it means that the house owner will come up to God. So the house owner is like, it's a phrase for Zeir Anpin, is coming up to Bina as well. והיצירה יתחבר בבריאה, so the יצירה, which is the related with the Iron Pin, will reconnect with the בריאה, וגם תשוב ה' לאה, and then the upper ה', which is the first ה', which is Bina, which is בריאה, אל בית מלכות, will come up to the palace, ורוזנים נרדו יחדה, and that will make the unity of אבא אנימה, אין הבנים שמחה. And then that's another pasuk that like the mother of the children is happy, meaning that Ima got back to her place. And the world of the Bria will reunite with the Atzilut. Okay, so this is like something that is general. Any tikkun is doing this process. And also here we have another section of that every tikkun is also tikkun for forbidden foods that we ate. So that's what we're going to read now. יעלו כל חלקי נפשות ורוחות ונשמות, that to make an elevation of all of the parts of נפש, רוח נשמה, שהיו בדומם צומח חי, that were in the mineral plantation and animals, that I ate, meaning they're in forbidden, like forbidden foods, ויחזרו אל הקדושה, all of that will come back to the holy side, מנוקות מכל רע, that will be clean from any negativity, ואת נפשותנו תתאר, you will pure our souls, ויהיה קרוב לשבתנו, come close when we are calling you, תרם נקרא אליך, as before we will even call you, ואתה תענה, you will already answer us, נדבר ואתה תשמע, you will hear us when we speak, כדבר שנאמר לה, כי תסז עם הפסוק, והיה תרם יקראו ואני אענה, עוד הם מדברים ואני אשמע. Right, so as before they will call me, I will answer. Before and as long while they are speaking, I'm already listening. Because you, Hashem, you are giving redemption and you are saving us. You answer us and you have mercy on us. We call it Sarav Zuka every time we have trouble and need. And you hear all of the prayers. Baruch Ata Hashem Shomea Tfila. Right. So if that's last. Like sentence, Baruch Ata Hashem Shomea Tefillah is if you are in the middle of Amida and you need to say Baruch Ata Hashem Shomea Tefillah to end the bracha, so then you finish with that. But if you don't, if you're doing it, saying it outside, so you say Baruch Ata Shomea Tefillah. Okay, you don't say Hashem name. Okay, and here in the corner here you have another addition if it is Friday, because Friday have a special meaning for Tikkunim. So if it is Friday, ביום שישי יוסיף זה. If you are in Friday, so you say this addition, very small. Don't worry, we're about to finish. כמו שהגן קדושת שבת על אדם הראשון, like the holiness of Shabbat have protected אדם הראשון, the first man, ויצא בדימוס, and because of the holiness of Shabbat, he came out like in an easier way, בדינו, in his judgment. כן, again, לנו, the same thing, the holiness of Shabbat will protect us. ותוציא לאור משפטנו, that you will bring our judgment to light, להאיר נרן, to enlighten our נפש רוח נשמה, בשבת, in the coming Shabbat, בתוספת מרובה, in a great addition, meaning a lot of abundance, לעבדך באמת, תמיד, to worship you truthfully forever, כל ימי חיינו, all of our days, היינה קרוב, so it jumps back here. So if in Friday, so instead of reading here straight, so you first read here and then you go back here, okay? In Friday, you're saying this extra prayer, and then you go back here and read and finishing here.
Okay. Yeah. That's why it's set up like this.
Yeah. Okay. That's it. So the next one is something else. Baruch Adonai Leolam. Amen. Amen.